Thank you. Connected the final beam, the entire tower began to vibrate with a powerful hum. A massive blast of sound shot out from the top of the tower. Meron was left dizzy and shaken from the blast. Was the Deeplight some kind of giant sonar beacon? If so, what had it been used for? With a terrible sinking feeling, she realized she already knew the answer. The Deeplight had been used to hunt the Marrows. The tower's sonar pulse had revealed a new location to her, but now she wanted to ensure it would never be activated again. The only way to be sure was to remove the sonar emitter. Yanked the emitter out of the Deeplight. The hum of the tower fell silent. She bolted the emitter into the roof of the sub. Maybe she could find a way to put it to good use.
Thank you.
when she saw the deep light's pulse. She was certain it must be the location of her father's boat. The gate of the Forbidden City, the clockwork seahorse warned her to stay away, but she had come this far and would not turn back, regardless of the danger that lay ahead. As the gate to the city opened, Meryn was ambushed by Fomori sentinels. Before she could react, they launched their torpedoes at the defenseless clockwork seahorse. Merrin watched in horror as its gleaming golden body was blasted into pieces that fell, lifeless and dull, to the sea floor. Blinded by rage, Merrin turned back to face the deadly sentinels. Forbidden city of the Fomori glistened with immeasurable riches. This was the lost city of gold from her father's songs. But where were the Fomori? Above the heart of the city lay the munitions factories. The weapon stockpiles were stacked in endless columns, awaiting a war that never came. Whatever had become of the Fomori, it must have been sudden and unexpected. Thank you. Forbidden City lay behind two enormous, impassable gates. They were sturdy enough to withstand the strongest creatures of the sea. Meryn was reminded of something her father once told her. When a problem seems unsolvable, approach it from another direction. Its cold and ruthless nature, Fomori weaponry was sometimes quite beautiful. Even their deadly, round warheads pulsed with a mesmerizing glow. Fomori warheads were designed to trigger on sound or light. They were sturdy enough to be pushed around, but a single sonar pulse or a strong beam would activate the detonator. Thank you. Riches and ever-turning gears of the Forbidden City came with their own cost.